What's up, guys? It's Yvonne, and in this video, I want to show you how to set up Google Ads conversion tracking with their brand new interface that they just recently rolled out. So let's get straight into it. So the first thing we're gonna do in our Google Ads account is click on Goals over here on the left-hand side, click on Conversions, and click on Summary. And you might see a certain chart here at the top. If you do, simply scroll down to where it says Create Conversion Action and click on that. I'm going to assume that you have Google Tag Manager installed. It's going to be super helpful for you for all your tracking for your website. But if you don't, I will go over ways to do that without Google Tag Manager as well. So this is their new interface where they have these little squares going from top to bottom as opposed to left to right. If you still see the old interface, which is quite possible, I see that on some of my accounts, going from left to right, then just check out my previous video, which I uploaded 2 months ago, which is also very, very new, to see how to set up conversion tracking for that interface. So in this case, we're going to scroll down here, and don't worry about this conversions offline Zapier, just ignore that. We're focused more on this option here, conversions on a website. So we're gonna click on edit over here, and we're gonna scan our site. The site we're gonna be using is called siteboosted.com for this example, and we're gonna wanna track sales, okay? So let's go back here, and this should say that the tag is added. So if you're using Google Tag Manager, then you don't have to do anything else here. Simply click on done, and we're gonna go to the next step. If you're not using Google Tag Manager, which I strongly recommend you use, it will make your life so much easier with any sort of tracking for your website, then you will need to add an additional code to your site. So in this case, let's suppose we enter some site that doesn't exist, and you will see a message saying that the Google tag is not installed on the site. So in this case, what you have to do is click on set up over here for the Google tag, and then we're gonna be installing this code manually. So you need to take this whole tag, you can click on copy right over here, or just copy it the way I did here, and add it in the head section of your website. So if you're using WordPress, for example, if we head over here, you can use a plugin called WP Code Lite. And what that's going to do is add this little option here on the left-hand side. You can click here, click on header and footer, and you will be able to add the code into the header part of your site. So in this case, you will simply take the code and add it right over here and click on Save Changes. If you're not sure where to find the tracking section of your site, just contact support for whatever site builder you're using and ask them where you're able to add the tracking code. And then what you would do is simply come in here, take this code and add it in that spot. Then you're gonna click on Test Installation and make sure that it works. Like I said, in our case, we already set it up using Tag Manager. So if we type in our site, siteboosted.com, the tag should already be installed. So we're gonna come in here and click on done. And now you see that everything is fine here. So we're gonna click on continue. And now we'll be able to choose what conversion category you want to track. Is it a purchase? Is it a lead? Is it a sign up? If you wanna see more, click on see all. Is it a submit lead form, book appointment? Any of these, take a look and find the one that matches your needs the best. The steps will be the same regardless of which conversion category you want to track. So in our case, we want to track sales. So we're gonna select purchase over here. And again, we're going to ignore the Zapier part at the top. And instead, we're just going to click on setup over here for Site Boosted. We're gonna select manual event. And then we're going to enter a name for the conversion. So in this case, for example, we could say purchase product. So we're going to click on use event. So now in order to access that same menu that they had by default before, I'm assuming Google thought it was too intimidating for beginners. If you want to access that menu again, you can click on settings over here and you see all your options here. So let me quickly go over them as well. So the primary action used for bidding versus secondary means how important is this action to you? If you're tracking different conversions, let's suppose a phone call and a lead submit and a sale, which one is the main one that you want to track and give Google signals for? Well, in our case, purchase is the end goal. So we want that to be our primary action. But if we also have, for example, a lead submit form, then maybe for the lead submit form, we want that to be a secondary action. We don't want Google to optimize for leads. We would want Google to optimize for sales. Does that make sense? Here we have the conversion name. Over here we have the different values. So if we're using Google Tag Manager, then we'll be able to have dynamically updated values. So on our website here, for example, we have different prices, $32, $24, $20, so on and so forth. So depending on the purchase that the user does, those values will be updated dynamically to reflect these values. So in our case here, we're going to leave it at use different values. We can enter some default value just in case the right value doesn't go through, like $20. So we're going to scroll down. Over here is the count, how many conversions to count per click. So if you have one person buy three different products, do you want that to count as three conversions or just one? In our case, of course, if it has to do with sales, we want to track every sale. However, if it's something like lead submit, if one person submits a form three times, well, we only want to count that once. So we're going to select one for that specific conversion. Does that make sense? So we're going to scroll down. Then you have these options here. I will briefly go over them as well. So the click-through conversion window is the number of days that you want to give after somebody clicks on your ad before no longer considered a conversion. So if you have 90 days here, for example, if somebody clicks on your ad today and in 95 days they make a sale, that will not be considered a conversion. On the contrary, if somebody clicks today and makes a sale in 60 days, for example, that will be considered a conversion. So the general rule of thumb is the higher value your product is, the more number of days you want to give it. The lower value your product is, the lower the days you want to give it. Think of buying a car or a house versus buying a pencil, right? If somebody sees your ad for selling pencils and then they buy a pencil half a year later, most likely that purchase had nothing to do with your ad, as opposed to buying a house, which has a much longer buyer cycle, right? So we're going to scroll down. Here you have engaged view conversion window. So this is after a video engagement. So this doesn't have any relevance if you're doing search ads, but the same concept applies. If somebody views your video today, how many days do you want to give them before the sale would actually be considered a conversion? You have a view through conversion window. So this is the same concept, but not people clicking your ad or seeing your video, but rather people seeing your ad. So not clicking on your ad, but just an impression. The default values for all of these are generally fine. I leave them as is. Next, you have the attribution. So before, Google had a bunch of settings, but they're now trying to simplify things, as you can see, try to make things much easier for people. So data-driven is the recommended. It was always the best option out of all of these, and now it is the default. And just to give you a brief description of what this is that if you have many different campaigns, many different ads, how do you want to attribute those sales? So if somebody has seen five of your ads, do you want each of those ads part of that conversion attributed to it? Or would you just like, for example, the last ad to have the full conversion? That would be last click. So data-driven is indeed recommended because Google will use their AI to identify how much each ad contributed to the final sale and give the corresponding percentage conversion to each of those. So we're gonna go with data-driven. Enhanced conversions here. We're going to leave this ad on for now. Don't worry about this because this is a topic to be discussed. This has to do with privacy and a cookie policy and all that stuff, which I don't want to overwhelm you in this video. But for the time being, to keep things simple, we're just going to leave that ad on and click on done. And that should be it for our event. So we're going to click on save and continue. And this is where you would get that event snippet code that I was telling you about. So if you're not using Google Tag Manager, you're going to click on see event snippet code here. And you would add this in between the head tags of the page you want to track. So again, if you're using WordPress, if you use that same plugin that I told you about, WP Code, you can click on add snippet here under code snippets, and you will be able to add that specific snippet code on a specific page, which is what you want, right? So in this case, if we're tracking sales, you would want to add this event snippet code on the thank you confirmation page, because that is the only page somebody will land on when a sale has occurred. So you would need to add this code to that thank you confirmation page. Now, if you're using Google Tag Manager, which is the easier way, then you need to copy this conversion ID and the conversion label. So let's head back over into our Google Tag Manager. We're gonna click on tags. We're going to click on new over here, and then let's give this a name. So let's say number one, just in case I have other purchases there. For tag configuration, we're gonna click here, we're gonna select Google Ads, we're gonna select Google Ads conversion tracking, and then we're gonna enter those values here. So with Google Tag Manager, like I said, makes things easier for you. We're gonna paste that there. We're gonna come in here, take this conversion label and paste it here. For the conversion value, transaction ID and currency code, you can just either leave them blank or enter a specific value corresponding to your purchase, to the transaction ID or the currency code. In this case, they will be dynamically updated, so we don't have to do anything else here. Next, we're going to scroll down and set the trigger. So on which page do we want this to fire on? So we've already set up the purchase page. So that's this one right here, the one that ends in order received, checkout slash order received, right? So we're gonna come in here and we're gonna select that page. That's this one right over here. So we're gonna click on that. And then just to show you what that looks like, so if we click over here, it's the page URL that contains this. So the page URL that contains this is our thank you confirmation page. So that's how we would do it with Google Tag Manager. So we're gonna close out of that. We're gonna hit save, and that should be it. Now you might also see a message saying one missing Google tag found. So that has to do with that initial code that I told you about that you don't have to worry about with Google Tag Manager. So if you do see this message, you can just click on fix over here and just click on add to workspace, and it's going to automatically add this Google tag to your Google Tag Manager. And that one's right over here. So you can click over here. And what this is Google is simply adding their code for your account. So that's this code right here. This is the code for our account. This number will not change. So they're adding this code to our entire website. That's what Google is doing here. As you can see here, they're adding it on all pages on our website because they want to see what's going on. And it allows you to set up tracking using their automated approach, which I might cover in a different video, but the manual one for now is the one I've been using and in my opinion is the best one because you can control every single part of it. But eventually they are heading towards these automated approaches, as you can see with all their recent changes. So this would be something good for you to add just to have. It's not gonna affect anything. So we're gonna get out of that. Now we can click on preview and we can test and we can make sure this is working. If you don't have Google Tag Manager, if you install the Google Pixel Helper, you will actually see something similar to this either way. So whether you're using Google Tag Manager or not, this is the preview mode for your site. So we're gonna click on connect and then we're gonna go through the process. We're gonna make a purchase and we're gonna see if that conversion has fired. So over here under Tag Assistant, we can see all the different conversions that fired. So their Google tag has fired, the one that we just recently added. And now we're looking for this specific code that we added, right? This one, the one called purchase number one. So let's come in here, let's make a purchase and just make sure that it works. We're gonna click on add to cart, view cart. Let's go to proceed to checkout. Scroll down, place order. And let's go back into our Tag Assistant and we should see that purchase number one right there, fired one time, and we see that Google Ads ID right over there that it has been affected as well. And if we click on purchase over here on the left-hand side and we click on variables, we will be able to see that the currency has been dynamically updated. So we can see here the currency is USD, we can see the transaction ID, and we can see the value is 2450, which corresponds to this value. If the value was anything other than 2450, then you would also see that value be reflected here. So that means everything is working well. So we can come in here, now we can just submit the changes. We can give this a name. Always give your saves a name. So we can say added Google Ads tags. We can hit publish. And now that code should be added successfully. And now you see that little message disappear. And if we go back to our Google Ads account, if we click on finish over here, you will see that new conversion action right over here. It says inactive for now, but give it just a few hours or so. Usually takes 15, 20 minutes for me, and it should say no recent conversions. When it says that, then you know that it's working successfully, just that no conversions have been recorded. So I'd say give it a few hours, load your website on and off just to make sure it's working, and you should see that new message there. So that is all. I hope this video was helpful. Like I said, I do cover tracking in very thorough detail for Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics in my upcoming membership site at yvonnemana.com/marketingblueprint. I invite you to check it out, to look at the video, to see what is included, all the different modules here that are included, and exactly the exact lessons. So this one I think is 6 to 8 hours long, the tracking and analytics module. And you can come in here and you can see exactly what is included. Within each of these lessons, there are many more. So for example, for this one, setting up events, I cover all the different events, phone calls, sales, lead submit form, button clicks, scrolls, time spent on page, things like that. And that is all. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video.